Many Muslims say that their faces don't fit either. As I was on my way to uncover that story, something unexpected happened, which brought the issue clearly into focus.
We've junked our plans and headed out of town because a few hours ago we heard that the main train from Delhi to Lahore in Pakistan was hit by a terrorist attack. There's talk of Muslim militants and dozens of deaths reported, so we're heading out to see what's actually happened.
Trains have become popular targets for terrorist attacks in India, often rooted in the tensions between India and Pakistan. For the 30 years it has linked the two countries, this train has been a symbol of hope for both sides, making its destruction all the more devastating. The fire is believed to have been started with suitcase bombs. I mean, just imagine this carriage, jam-packed with people, in total panic. You can't get out because there's bars on the windows. You can't get out of the door because the doors are locked. And the thing you have to remember is that it is so hard to get permission to go from Pakistan to India or vice versa, that the people on this train would have been making literally a once-in-a-lifetime journey. They wouldn't have been able to do this under normal circumstances, and this is where their journey's ended. At the nearby hospital, 65 bodies are awaiting burial, many of them badly charred. Bags of ice are being used to keep them preserved in the hope that relatives can identify them.
Who is she?
Bhabhi. Pakistan ja rahi thi, Lahore ja rahi thi. Apne bhatijon se milne ke liye. Humne yahan fir dekha to hume pehchan mein nahi aaya, lekin hum dobara jab unke paas aaye na to dekha to passport wagaira mila. Usse humne pehchan ki. बहुत ही गलत है इससे आतंकवादियों के काम तो पूरे होते नहीं है इसमें इंसान है चाहे वो हिंदू हो या मुसलमान हो इनसे उनके मंसूबे पूरे नहीं होते
There have long been tensions between Hindus and Muslims, at times erupting into communal violence. 5 years ago, the state of Gujarat was hit by some of India's worst rioting. It's reported that up to 2,000 people were killed, mostly Muslims, as Hindu mobs went on the rampage. It followed an attack on a train in which 59 Hindu pilgrims had been killed. Human rights organizations claimed the mobs had been stirred up by the politics of Hindu nationalism. On the outskirts of Delhi, thousands have come to honor the late M.S. Gowalkar, one of the original leaders of the RSS, a Hindu nationalist group. The RSS believes the country should be a Hindu state, claiming that all Indians are Hindu in origin, regardless of their current religion. The uniforms may look Boy Scout, but Gowalkar was an admirer of Hitler in 1930s Germany, and said India could learn from his ideas of racial and cultural purity. After the Gujarat riots, today's leaders stated that the safety of Muslims lies in the goodwill of the majority. But they deny being anti-Muslim. Today's speeches praise Hinduism and use coded language without identifying the enemy.
तुम्हें निश्चय करना है कि अगर देश द्रोही सूली पर नहीं चढ़ाया गया तो निश्चित देश सूली पर चढ़ेगा इसीलिए कातिलों की मुक्ति के विधान इस देश में नहीं होने चाहिए देश द्रोहियों की आरती इस देश में नहीं होनी चाहिए वंदनियों का वंदन होना चाहिए और दंडनियों को दंड मिलना चाहिए
The idea of a Hindu nation has entered the mainstream of Indian politics. The RSS has close links with the former party of government, the BJP.
Up on that stage is the man who was Prime Minister up until a couple of years ago, his former Home Minister, and an ex-Vice President. This is not a fringe meeting.
The former Prime Minister, A.B. Vajpayee, recited an inspirational poem. As I left the rally, some of the younger supporters were certainly fired up. It's a charming chant. When the nation calls, we will go with a blessing of bullets. I decided to take a look for myself, posing as an investor from London. One of my colleagues followed with a hidden camera. Another acted as translator. I wanted to know what kinds of people lived in the complex.
The people who live here, they're nice. It's a good area.
Yeah, he said to them.
Businessmen,
professionals.
Activists say it's time for action, and they're using street meetings like this to urge Muslims to stand up for their rights. When this was a nation in which a million people died at its founding, there's been communal violence ever since, and there's still ongoing discrimination. I went to the RSS Founders Day rally where they were saying, India for the Hindus.